Now it'll be Patrick Breyer from the Greens. Are you there, Patrick? Ready to go?
Yes, I am.
Please do.
Thank you, Chair. Now, regarding the tragedy of the recent terrorist attacks, let me stress that we are all shocked by what has happened. However, we may never give up our values. We need to stand up for fundamental rights and freedom of speech, which, by the way, Samuel Paty, for example, had to die for. Terrorist attacks are attacking us precisely for our fundamental freedoms, so we must never let them succeed by curtailing ourselves these freedoms in reaction to terrorist attacks. Now, police have unfortunately repeatedly failed to watch perpetrators long known to them before they committed terrorist acts, for example, in the case of Austria. And I've recently spoken to an victim's attorney. Would you agree, Commissioner, that there is no deficit in surveillance powers, but a deficit in enforcement regarding terrorism? And also, would you agree that online platforms should report manifest terrorist content to law enforcement for prosecution? Why is this reporting element missing from your proposal that would make sure that terrorist content is actually prosecuted? I'm very concerned to hear your plans regarding the possible expansion of bulk collection of information on non-suspected travelers in the EU, regarding passenger information concerning a train and ferry travel. Would you agree that we have a right to travel anonymously within the EU? That is part of the freedom to move within the EU. And are you aware that Council has not adopted its resolution on widening the scope of PNR precisely because this has been a very controversial issue and the European Court of Justice is only just considering the PNR directive? So in this opinion on the Canadian PNR agreement, the European Court of Justice said it is disproportionate to retain our passenger data for years. May I ask you, Commissioner, when will you put forward your proposal to revise the PNR directive to make it compliant with our fundamental rights? And likewise, on data retention, we've had fundamental judgments recently. Will you start infringement proceedings to those member states that do not comply with these judgments? And if I may make a last remark, Chair, on the encryption. We've had this debate before. It's essential to internet safety, and we need to decide between safe communications and interceptability. So I would like to hear your opinion, Commissioner. Will you compromise safe encryption to make it interceptable, or do you think safety online is more important? Thank you.
Many of you have asked about encryption, and that's a very, of course, difficult issue. It's important to enhance cybersecurity for the protection of fundamental rights, such as privacy. At the same time, encryption can also be used by predators seeking a secure channel to hide their actions from law enforcement and judiciary. So this is, and that could make it very, very difficult to investigate, to detect and prosecute criminal offenses. So that's why we said in the Security Union strategy that we presented this summer, that we will explore and support a balanced technical, operational and legal solutions and promote an approach which both maintains the effectiveness of encryption in protecting privacy and securing security of communication, but also effective tools for law enforcement. And I think that's why our role as politicians is to find the right balance here.